there are three main agencies ruling the country.
Right.
One is the politicians.
Hmm.
Second is the bureaucrats.
Hmm.
Or if I reorder it correctly, first are the bureaucrats.
Yes.
Second are the politicians. Third are the services. Yeah. I mean, ABFOs.
Yes.
Now, the bureaucrats have adopted the brown culture, the British culture.
Hmm.
They think they are the elitist of the elite in India.
Babu.
after the British left, they adopted the color of brown sahib. So, they became brown sahib and they are the rulers.
Hmm.
That is why all these years, India has not grown constitutionally, politically, defense-wise, because of the control that they don't want to lose. Unfortunately, most of the politicians are criminals.
Right.
I know I'm making these kind of tall words, but that's the reality of life.
Everyone knows it.
Everybody knows, the whole of the country knows. So why shy about it?
Yeah.
They're criminal. Large number of good politicians and nationalists are not having this military strategic knowledge of how to go about defending the sovereignty of the country.
Yes.
What is required to be done, whether nuclear, whether conventional, whatever. And the third is the Army, Navy, Air Force, who are sitting ready.
Right.
Being apolitical, being very, very dedicated nationalists, but waiting for instructions to go.
Right.
But unless they are prepared, how will they go to war?
Right.
So the biggest agency that is actually sorting India out is the bureaucracy.
Hmm.
And the biggest enemies, I don't hesitate to say, the biggest enemies of defense forces are the bureaucrats of Ministry of Defense.
Hmm.
Do you know how many they have granted 37 undersecretaries and joint secretaries as under the CDS, totaling to, not 37, I think 42 is the number of the secretaries now authorized under the CDS.
Right.
So that means CDS is one man in uniform with 42 of the bureaucrats.
Okay.
So how will the CDS function? It's a victory for bureaucracy.
Mm-hmm.
42 additional vacancies granted against one CDS.
Okay.
And maybe 2-3 people under him as staff officers.
But what if he actually needs itna, like, you know, people to work under him?
You see, the point is the politicians have failed to understand what the bureaucrats are doing. They're fooling the politicians.
Oh.
They're not giving full knowledge to the politician.
Right.
They keep them at bay and they hide this information, and very gradually they are taking away all the perks.
Right.
Your OROP, your NFU, non-functional upgrade,
right,
not granted to Army. Do you know where the Army stands today? Army is below the Central Armed Police Forces.
Okay.
IPS, IFS, IRS,
right,
Railway Services, Revenue Services, bureaucrats,
yes,
are all above Army.
Yes.
In pay and in the precedence of,
yes,
order of precedence.
The Central Forces, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They've succeeded. They've gone ahead. And, you know, the defense services are not A class. They are bloody B class. Made B class. Whereas a foreign and a revenue or a railway service chap is an A class officer.
Mm.
And the commissioned officer. Here is the point I want to make.
Right.
People should understand that bureaucrats are the servants, civil servants, this is an official term, civil servants of the people of India.
Yes.
They are knockers,
right,
servants,
right,
whereas the officers of Army, Navy, Air Force are president's commission.
Hmm.
They're commissioned officers. How,
yes,
the hell can they be B class and these servants become A class?
Yes.
That is the irony.
Hmm.
That is the irony which needs to be corrected.
Right. Nice.